Dan bukan hanya saya guys, namun kita sudah melihat bukti, ya, memang kita akui Malaysia ini ternyata antara tiga negara tersebut, Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, dia lebih memilih negara. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Halo guys, apa kabar hari ini? Kita berjumpa lagi tentunya seperti biasa. Saya akan menyapa Anda semua di sana. Semoga kita dalam keadaan baik-baik saja, sehat senantiasa jasmani juga rohaninya, serta segala bentuk pekerjaan, aktivitas, kegiatan apapun yang kita kerjakan di dalam maupun di luar rumah, semoga diberikan kemudahan dan kelancaran oleh Tuhan Yang Maha Kuasa. Amin, amin ya Rabbal Alamin. Baik, di sini ada satu kisah, satu cerita yang unik dan menarik lainnya yang akan kita bahas nih guys ya, tentang hal apakah itu. Oke, di sini ada satu cerita dari gadis cantik asal Filipina ya guys ya. Jadi dia ini sedang berkuliah. So, seorang mahasiswi cantik lah ya guys ya. Seorang mahasiswi cantik ini dia berkuliah di negaranya yaitu adalah Filipina. Namun ada masanya ya guys ya, kalau di universitas itu kita sama-sama mengetahui ada pertukaran mahasiswa. Jadi terjadilah kepada wanita ini pertukaran mahasiswa ke negara lain ya. Jadi di sini mahasiswi ini memilih ada tiga negara yang paling direkomendasikan untuk dia kunjungi ya guys ya. Salah satu university yang paling bagus di tiga negara tersebut ya. Tiga negara itu adalah Thailand, Indonesia, dan juga Malaysia. Nah, ini menarik ya guys ya. Ada tiga negara yang direkomendasikan, ada Thailand, Malaysia, dan Indonesia. Jadi, saya nggak tahu ini guys ya, karena dia memilih satu negara ya. Karena dia mewajibkan untuk masuk ke satu negara, university terbaik di negara tersebut. So, di sini dia lebih memilih apa guys? Lebih memilih negara mana? Ternyata, antara tiga negara tersebut, dia lebih memilih negara Malaysia. Wow, guys ya. Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia. Dia lebih memilih negara Malaysia di salah satu university terbaik yang ada di negara itu, guys ya. Nah, kalau menyinggung tentang Thailand, ya, pastinya ada university terkenal dan berkualitas di negara gajah perang tersebut, ya, guys ya. Namun, secara spesifikasi, saya belum banyak mengetahui tentang negara itu. Tapi kalau di negara saya sendiri, di Indonesia tentu ada banyak juga ya university terbaik di negara Indonesia seperti UI, ITB, Pajajaran, dan lain sebagainya ya guys ya, yang memiliki akreditasi A. Tapi mengapa dia lebih memilih university yang ada di Malaysia? Mengapa tidak di negara kami Indonesia guys ya? Tentunya ada alasan-alasan tersendiri yang membuat saya penasaran di sini. Dia akan mengungkapkan alasan tersebut di video ini, guys ya. Apa sih penyebabnya? Karena dia lebih pilih Malaysia daripada Thailand, daripada Indonesia, dia lebih memilih Malaysia. Dan secara terang-terangan dia mengatakan hal tersebut ya. Setelah dia berkuliah di Malaysia, ya, dia semakin dekat dengan negara itu ya, guys ya. Sebenarnya apa sih faktor utamanya? Oke, kita akan saksikan video itu. Tanpa banyak berbasa-basi, kita langsung menuju videonya. Ini dia.
Is at sea and I'm back in the Philippines. I'm sorry for my setup right now. It's been a long time. It's been like 3 months since I went back here in the Philippines, and actually it still feels surreal up until now when I look at the videos I took when I was in Malaysia. It's still like still a little bit hard for me to grasp, not so easy for me to talk about leaving Malaysia. It's not that a light topic for me. So first we have here, what made me choose Malaysia? What makes you choose to continue your study in Malaysia? And if not Malaysia, what is your second choice? Honestly, under AIMS, I had three choices: Indonesia, Thailand, and Malaysia. And for me, Malaysia is like the best choice because aside from the fact that it is a Muslim country, which is something that I really dreamed of going to,
Malaysia, I think, is a lot better in a sense that
in terms of like education, they have much more higher ranking institutions. So that's why I chose Malaysia, and I could credit a lot more subjects when I chose the universities in Malaysia. So that's why I chose Malaysia. And aside from that, Malaysia is also close to Singapore, which is another like my dream country. So that's why I chose it. If not, then what is your second choice? Well, I had.
Kita pause di sini dulu, guys ya. Ternyata salah satu hal yang menguatkan dia untuk lebih memilih Malaysia, karena memang dia mengetahui ya pendidikan di Malaysia adalah salah satu yang terbaik di ASEAN. Itu artinya lebih mengedepankan tentang pendidikan ya guys di negara itu. Dan yang kedua itu adalah lebih dekat daripada Singapura ya. Jadi kalau dia pergi berkuliah pada saat hari bercuti, dia bisa lebih dekat ke Singapura ya guys ya, untuk berlibur seperti itu ya. Oke, kita lanjutkan lagi.
Like. Thailand and Indonesia was like very close to one another as my second choice.
I consider Indonesia because it's also a Muslim country, but I heard a lot of people saying that Indonesia looks very similar to Philippines.
I haven't really heard a lot about institutions there. I haven't really done any research since I already targeted Malaysia.
But I did consider one of the universities there because the facilities are very good. And then I also have like Mahidol University from Thailand. I also considered that, but then the deadline was already done after I tried applying for it, so
I ended up applying to three universities in Malaysia,
which is University Putra Malaysia, UITM Shah Alam, and UKM, University Kebangsaan Malaysia. Are you able to adjust yourself in Malaysia so far? How fluent are you now in Bahasa Melayu? Hi semua, this is my first time speaking in Malay again after 3 months. We spoke English all the time, and I think I spoke more Korean more than speaking Bahasa Melayu when I went there. So, okay, hi semua, nama saya Itzy. Saya dari Filipin. Saya berasal dari Filipin. Terima kasih banyak. Languages do you know? Are you interested in learning new languages? In Philippines, I technically speak Tagalog and English. Filipino and English, these two are our official languages.
But then, the thing is that we are so diverse and there's a lot of like tribes here in Mindanao, so technically I speak another two languages,
which is Bisaya, and the other one is a dialect, which is Maguindanao.
We have four inside the Philippines to just give you like how, like to let you know how different they are. They say good morning in English, right? And magandang umaga in Tagalog. And
in Bisaya, maayong buntag. And Maguindanaon, which is my tribe's language, Yamapita. This is how different they are. Maybe let's add Korean. Yeah, I think y'all have watched my videos already. So next one, I can read and write Arabic.
I think that is like mostly in among the Muslim people.
What else? Bahasa Melayu. But my Bahasa Melayu is so bad. I can only count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's the same in Tagalog. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I forgot to say 11. So. Guys, my Malay is so bad, so
I don't know if I can consider it as like another language that I can speak, but maybe put it on the beginner level.
I saw here someone asking why do I blur my face. Well, mainly it's because of the privacy.
You know, internet is a very, very scary place.
And that's why, like, there's a lot of like deepfake and stuff, and
there's just so many things going on in the internet, and we cannot just
simply trust. And especially in my YouTube channel where I share a lot of like personal things, I don't think
sharing my face, how I look like, would help. So yeah.
So, three best places you've been in KL. I don't really want to answer this because KL is like not tiny, but like
it's more condensed, so I really cannot give a lot of like answers for this one, but let's make it like three best places you've been to in Malaysia rather. Okay.
Only the mainland area, not yet in somewhere Sabah, Sarawak, is it? Well, inshallah, I'm really planning to go there. Like, I could technically go there by ferry or boat, but it's just that for some reasons
I have to take like 1, 2, 3 flights.
Yeah, 3 flights just to get there. Maybe I'll put first Putrajaya. Putrajaya is just so clean and it left me a very good impression. And you need to give an impression, like a very strong impression, that you can actually survive overseas alone.
Because since in my case, I went to UPM alone, I wanted to take risk of going into a university that was the first, as a first student, to be sent by UM. And so, and I was also the first one, this is another thing, the first exchange student under my course, which is legal management. So it was very challenging because technically I don't have like any mentors or like anyone who had been in my situation before. There's a lot of like firsts with me, but
it's all about taking risk, and alhamdulillah, I would be nothing without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help, like literally. And I also had like a lot of challenges in between, but I don't really want to talk about it now. Just utilize all of the search engines, especially in Google, like search for stuff like that. And yeah, you will be good, inshallah. Let's proceed to the next question. How is the education in Malaysia? I've received a lot of questions about how is Malaysia when it comes to like education. For me, I could only speak for UPM, so I hope this will be enough.
And I can also speak for the experiences of my fellow exchange students who went to UKM and University Malaya.
So overall, the Malaysia education life is a lot more laid back compared to the Philippines, especially in University of Mindanao, where we have like every 2 weeks we have our examinations, while in Malaysia it's like very chill and very laid back type of like curriculum. There are a lot of like organizations that you can join, organizations and clubs, and the fact that these opportunities are actually very important, especially when it comes to like networking. I'm very particular when it comes to networking and how useful this is into your career and into your life in general. At UPM, there's like a lot of events going on that you will never get bored. Like, you will never get bored, like literally, I'm not kidding.
And I don't really want to sugarcoat as much as possible, but the teachers and the professors there can also speak English. There's this class that I have
where I am the only like mobility student that is like microeconomics, but then despite that the professor would still speak in English, and I'm very glad and I really appreciate this because not all lecturers are as considerate as like that one. And another thing is that
we only had 3 examinations in total in a span of like how many months was it? It's like 1 semester.
And thankfully for me, like, I traveled a lot during my exchange, right? Despite that, I had like a decent grade. I feel pretty embarrassed about this topic, but
yeah, I feel like all throughout my exchange, I haven't really focused a lot when it comes to academics because I really made time to enjoy just my exchange. And the fact that the subjects I took there are also minor, that's why I did not really pay so much attention as much as I would pay attention if I was here in the Philippines.
I don't really discard all of my hard work. I still studied, you know? I still studied, but it's not just as hard as what I did here in the Philippines. And they don't have Saturday classes, and they only have, like, the system of classes there is that
it's only 3 hours per week, but then 2 hours is allotted for one day and another hour for the next day or like another day.
Because unlike here in the Philippines, the system here is common like Monday to Saturday class.
Yeah, I'm not kidding.
But that's the reality here. In no way I am bashing Philippines here, but I am stating facts when it comes to educational system in the Philippines and in Malaysia. And it's also very inclusive there since diversity is existent everywhere there, right?
Because of that, like, the teachers and the professors there tend to be more considerate when it comes to their students. And it's just so good, and they're also very responsive in WhatsApp.
But I'm speaking all of these things based on my experience in UPM, okay?
Okay guys, video yang baru saja kita saksikan dan ini juga tidak kalah menariknya ya. Ini terkait tentang pendidikan. Iya, university mana yang dia pilih? Tadi dikatakannya bahwa UPM, ya, University Putra Malaysia ya, kalau tidak salah seperti itu. Kalau saya salah, mohon dibetulkan di kolom komentar ya guys ya. Jadi dia sangat tegaskan di sini, dia tekankan bahwa dia lebih pilih Malaysia, ya, itu karena memang Malaysia dia anggap ya satu negara yang lebih mengedepankan tentang dunia pendidikan. Dan bukan hanya itu ya, kita juga tahu bukan hanya pendidikan, namun juga kesehatan di Malaysia itu memang sudah levelnya sangat tinggi ya guys ya. Tapi ya, tapi ini bukan untuk kita merendahkan satu kawasan, satu negara ya, negara Thailand juga Indonesia bukan seperti itu ya. Karena pendidikan di Indonesia dan di Thailand itu juga tidak kalah baiknya, juga bagus. Tapi ini menurut saya hanya selera dan pendapat dia saja guys ya. Dia lebih memilih Malaysia karena memang kita sama-sama mengetahui ya, ya pendidikan di Malaysia itu lebih adaptif terkait tentang modernisasi teknologi ya, yang mana itu lebih memacu kita untuk lebih mempelajari lagi tentang ilmu teknologi dan juga upgrade teknologi tersebut ya guys ya. Karena tiap tahun itu pasti ada teknologi-teknologi canggih yang harus kita pelajari. Nah, terkait tentang pendidikan Malaysia ini ya, Malaysia ini lebih adaptif lagi terkait tentang kemajuan teknologi tersebut ya guys ya. Contoh seperti kereta listrik ya, seperti itu ya. Maka mungkin di ilmu pengetahuan di negara-negara lain belum mempelajari hal itu, kemungkinan karena adanya teknologi tinggi yang mewajibkan untuk seseorang mempelajari teknologi itu, maka di Malaysia itu sudah masuklah kurikulum atau bagian dari kurikulum dari pelajaran itu guys, kereta ataupun mobil listrik ya guys ya. Nah, ini adalah satu contoh yang sangat baik, yang sangat positif. Sudah tentu ini tentu akan menimbulkan lagi ya persaingan di setiap university yang ada, karena semakin tinggi level pendidikannya maka kualitas masyarakat yang ada di sana itu tentu semakin maju ya guys ya. Karena pendidikan dan juga kesehatan memang menjadi tonggak bangunan ya, tonggak bangunan dari sebuah negara. Bila tonggak itu kuat ya guys ya, dari pendidikan dan juga kesehatan, maka negara itu berpotensi akan lebih cepat maju dan lebih cepat berkembang ya guys ya, jauh meninggalkan negara yang mungkin belum banyak mengetahui, mempelajari sisi-sisi yang sudah kita katakan tadi. Dan bukan hanya saya guys, namun kita sudah melihat bukti bahwa ada ratusan ribu mahasiswa pelajar dari Indonesia itu yang menempuh pendidikannya ke Malaysia. Memang kita akui Malaysia ini lebih baik ya di bidang pendidikannya daripada negara-negara lain yang ada di ASEAN selain Singapura. Kita akui itu guys ya. Ya, secara faktanya memang sudah terbukti hal tersebut ya. Tapi mungkin di dalam negeri di Indonesia ini sudah mengetahui ya guys ya perbedaan hal itu, jadi sudah mulai mengejar ketertinggalan itu. Ya, karena kita bahas tadi guys ya, teknologi itu setiap tahun itu pasti ada saja ya hal-hal yang menarik, hal-hal yang baru saja terwujud tentang teknologi tersebut ya. Kalau tidak kita pelajari, maka kita akan jauh lebih tertinggal di bidang teknologi itu. So, di sini, mengapa dia lebih pilih Malaysia? Dan juga ini terkait tentang apa, guys? Hari bercuti. Nah, dia sangat suka dengan hal itu, ya. Selain saat hari Senin, ya, atau di Malaysia itu mengatakan Isnin, ya. Senin sampai hari Jumat itu berfokus untuk pelajaran, belajar, 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 belajar. Namun di hari Sabtu Minggu, mereka itu berlibur, ya. Refleksi pikiran, ya. Bisa mereka berlibur kemana-mana ya guys ya, seperti itu ya. Namun kalau di Filipina ternyata kuliah mereka sampai hari Sabtu ya guys. Jadi batas waktu untuk libur tuh cuman di hari Minggu saja. Tapi apapun itu ya, bukan berarti di Indonesia dan di Thailand itu jelek guys ya, karena pendidikan itu di Thailand dan Indonesia juga sangat berkualitas. Namun kembali lagi, dia lebih memilih Malaysia karena sudah banyak bukti bahwa orang-orang Indonesia juga bersekolah atau berkuliah di Malaysia, dan juga orang-orang Timur Leste juga banyak berkuliah di Malaysia. Nah, ini menjadi dasar, ya, menjadi pilihan dia untuk menetapkan Malaysia sebagai tempat dia menempuh pendidikan tersebut. Seperti itu ya, guys, ya. Dan ini hanya terkait selera saja. Baiklah, demikian tadi video aku. Semoga video ini bermanfaat bagi kita semua, dan aku mohon diri, mohon maaf jika ada kesalahan, kesalahan sikap pada Anda semua. Mohon dimaafkan, dan aku akhiri. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.